Hello student, today we will see recursive decomposition under unit number 2. We know that there are four decomposition techniques. First one is data decomposition, second one is recursive decomposition, third one is speculative decomposition, and last one is hybrid decomposition. Recursive decomposition is a method for inducing concurrency in problem that can be solved using divide and conquer strategy. In this technique, a problem is solved by first dividing into a set of independent subproblems. Each one of these subproblems is solved by recursively applying a similar division into smaller subproblems followed by combination of their results. The divide and conquer strategy result in natural concurrency as the different subproblems can be solved concurrently. So this is a recursive decomposition generally suited to the problem that can be solved using divide and conquer strategy. A given problem is first decomposed into set of subproblems. These subproblems are recursively decomposed further until a desired granularity is reached. Now the example of this recursive decomposition is quicksort. So as shown in this figure, a classic example of divide and conquer algorithm on which we can apply recursive decomposition is quicksort. Okay, as shown in the figure, consider the problem of sorting a sequence of n element using commonly used quicksort algorithm. Quicksort is a divide and conquer algorithm that starts by selecting a pivot element x and then partition the sequence A into two subsequences A0 and A1 such that all the elements in A0 are smaller than x and all the elements in A1 are greater than or equal to x. This partitioning forms the divide step of the algorithm. Each one of the subsequences A0 and A1 is sorted by recursively calling quicksort. Each of these recursively calls further partition the subsequences. This is shown in this figure. Now the list is given and this list is divided into two sublists. Okay. Initially the pivot element is 5 and then with respect to that pivot element the list is left hand side list is created and the right hand side list is created. Again every time the pivot element in subsequent list is selected and that is further divided. So in this example, once the list has been partitioned around the pivot, each sublist can be processed concurrently. That is, each sublist represents the independent subtask. This can be repeated recursively. So this is an example of recursive decomposition. The problem is decomposed till we get the desired level of granularity. Recursive decomposition, this quicksort example, okay, is shown previously. Now another example is the problem of finding the minimum number in given list is explained here. Okay, so this problem, as shown in this pseudocode, initially all the elements are obtained and then we can use a pseudocode like if a of I is less than minimum, then minimum is equal to a of I. In this way, a minimum number in the given list is find out. So this list is divided till we get the minimum number. This is an example of recursive decomposition. Now here the actual procedure of recursive decomposition is explained, where the given list is divided into two subpart and every time a given number is compared with the left hand side and the right hand side, every time the left hand side list is divided and right hand side is also divided till we desire or till we get the desired granularity. This is a recursive decomposition. Okay, now another decomposition technique is exploratory decomposition. What is the exploratory decomposition? Exploratory decomposition is used to decompose the problem whose underlying computation corresponds to search of space for solution. In exploratory decomposition, we partition the search space into smaller parts and search each one of these parts concurrently until the desired solution are found. Now, as shown here, in many cases, the decomposition of problem goes hand in hand with its execution. This problem typically involves the exploration of the state of space of solution. Problem in this class includes variety of discrete optimization problem, theorem proving, game playing, etc. One of the example of this exploratory decomposition is 15 puzzle problem. The 15 puzzle consist of 15 tiles numbered 1 through 15 and one blank tiles placed in 4x4 grids. A tile can be moved into a blank position from the position adjacent to it, thus creating a blank in the tiles in a single position. Depending on the configuration of the grid, up to 4 moves are possible: up, down, left, and right. The initial and the final configuration of the tiles are specified. The objective is to determine any sequence or the shortest sequence of the moves that transform the initial configuration of the final configuration. As shown in this figure, 15 puzzle problem is given. Now, this is a simple application of exploratory decomposition in a solution to 15 puzzle. We show the sequence of 3 moves that transform a given initial state A to desired final state B, as shown here. So you can move the element into the blank space, you can move the element into the up or left or right till we reach to the desired level of granularity. So this is a exploratory decomposition. It is specifically used for discrete optimization problem, theorem proving, game playing, etc. Now, the exploratory decomposition example, the state space can be explored by generating various successor states of current states and to view these as independent tasks. Now you can see here, the original scenario of this 15 puzzle problem is here, and then that is divided into 4 subtasks. Again, that task are explored till we reach to the final answer. Now, like this, this will be continued till the final result will be achieved. That is a exploratory decomposition. Okay. Now, exploratory decomposition, autonomous computation. In many instances of exploratory decomposition, the decomposition technique may change the amount of work done by parallel formulation. This change result in super or sublinear speedup. So, later on, a speculative decomposition, this method is the last method of a decomposition technique. So in some application, dependencies between tasks are not known prior. For such application, it is impossible to identify independent tasks. So there are generally 2 approaches to dealing with such applications. Conservative approach, which identify independent tasks only when they are guaranteed to not have dependencies, and optimistic approach, which schedule the task even when they may potentially errorness. So conservative approach may yield little concurrency, and optimistic approach may require rollback mechanism in case of error. A classic example of speculative decomposition is in discrete event simulation. A central data structure in a discrete event simulation is the time ordered event list. Events are extracted precisely in time order process, and if required, resulting events are inserted back into event list. Consider your day-to-day as a discrete event system. You get up, get ready, drive to work, eat lunch, work sometime, drive back, eat dinner, and sleep. Each of these events may be processed independently. However, if suppose that sometimes you not feel well, or there is a sudden accident happens in your driving, then all of the successive events are collapsed. So that is a problem with speculative decomposition. Speculative decomposition example. Another example in speculative decomposition is the simulation of the network of nodes. For instance, an assembly line or a computer network through which the packet pass. The task is to simulate the behavior of this network for various inputs and nodes delay parameter. Note that networks may become unstable for certain values of rates, queue size, etc. So this is a speculative decomposition example, simulation of network of nodes. Okay. Now we have seen the four decomposition techniques: light form, data decomposition, recursive decomposition, speculative decomposition. Okay. Now all these can be combined with each other, and that becomes a hybrid decomposition. Often a mix of decomposition techniques is necessary for decomposing a problem. Consider the following example. In quicksort, recursive decomposition alone limits concurrency. A mix of data and recursive decomposition is more desirable. In discrete event simulation, there might be concurrency in task processing. A mix of speculative decomposition and data decomposition may work well, even for simple problem like finding a minimum of the list of numbers. A mix of data and recursive decomposition work well. So that is a combination of two decomposition technique is a hybrid decomposition. So student, I hope that you clear with all the four techniques of decomposition, right from data decomposition to this hybrid decomposition. So this is the end of decomposition techniques, a very important article. Surely there will be a question in your final examination for these decomposition techniques. Okay. Now, thank you very much. Goodbye.